Yes, thank you very much for the invitation, Ms. Briasuli, Professor Briasuli. Okay, after so much biology and genetics, a little bit sociology, it's okay. This is to change a little the attitude of the presentation. I want to present to you the assemblage and disassemblage of a generation, the case of Greek youth. This is the result of a research we have conducted between 2012 and 2015. And this is only one aspect, one theoretical and empirical aspect of our research. And we will be very happy to have some comments on this, because we think this a new way to understand generations in sociology. The presentation aims to showcase an analytical and theoretical effort for a new perception of youth as a social concept, avoiding the stereotypical methodology that is commonly used, which often leads to a political and administrative construction of youth based mainly on formal statistics or state employment programs. Indeed, it seems that it's an extremely difficult task to identify youth and young people today in a way that will allow us to record accurately their social and cultural characteristics, as well as the important contemporary social phenomena that define them. Data collected through the research program InforYouth contributed to the expansions of the pre-existing theoretical model for youth, as well as a reflection on the various efforts young people undertake during their transition from education to work. The concept of youth as a social concept can be approached in another way through the succession of generations, a subject that begins with Karl Mannheim's sociological analysis. For Mannheim, social integration takes place in two ways. One is through specific groups such as communities and social associations, in which members maintain conscious and concrete social ties. And the second is through belonging in a group through the common integration into a structure, whether this is done consciously or as a result of their objective characteristics, such as the placement or inclusion in a social class or a generation. Eisenstadt, an American sociologist, tried to identify age groups as a sociological phenomenon in societies that are no longer characterized by particularity, that is to say, by the social division linked to family and affinity, which characterizes all traditional societies. These questions remain unanswered to a certain extent by Eisenstadt's theory, particularly in relation to the subcultures that contradict the structured social order. Is youth a formative social power? The social group of young people can thus be seen as an emerging generation whose members, beyond their common biological ages, are characterized by the particular integration of their generations in the social structures and functions of society, while at the same time having acquired a specific formative social power in relation to the previous generations in order to succeed in the modern social environment. Our theoretical synthesis. In the theoretical synthesis of the two aforementioned models, Mannheim and Eisenstadt, presented in our analysis, we inserted the methods of dialectics and assemblage. Perhaps Mrs. Delander has some objections to the word dialectics.
Already I have objections.
This is achieved through the reconstitutions of the old world through new forms of social practice, merged with social organizations, and the introduction of completely new forms of social life, as well as the use of technology and ways of communications that did not exist in the past. Presenting the four dimensions that follow, we describe the most characteristic changes and processes that derive from a real generation, but also comprise its constitutive elements. Each generation is defined by its common social characteristics. This includes the age group and the new social indicators that lead to the construction or preservation of the objective image of young people's presence in the productive system and class positions, and more specific in the social relationship, family, kinship, education, and employment. Second, each generation is defined by shared historical experiences. Historical experiences and the collective narrative of society around important events and historical persons are arbitrarily negotiated by emerging generations, a situation that can lead to their reinterpretation, rejection, or even conservative reclassification. Third, the emerging cultural spirit of each era is able to lead to a dynamic introduction of a new innovative waves of change in culture, knowledge, values, and performances to the social hierarchy, or even to restore values and standards from a distant past. Fourth, each generation is defined by a specific generational life cycle. The life cycle of society members is driven by the presence of a new historical generation that has in turn dialectically adapted the temporality and phase of the life cycle and introduces a new paradigm of youth and especially of adulthood. This is our concept, a graphical presentation of this concept. We have the four processes, and in the middle, in the center, the emergence of a generation. One is the zeitgeist, the age group, youth life cycle, and shared historical experience. All these contribute to the emergence or not of a generation. And this is different factors that are positive, strong, or less strong, and all these are contributing to the emergence of a generation. Youth is a distinct social entity. In our research, we try to determine whether young people are able, at the same time, influence and participative with different intensity in each distinct factor and process as we initially posited. As a whole, the four processes help us understand youth as a distinct, real social entity, as well as a functional participatory part of the overall society. However, the understanding of youth through the four dimensions is only possible through the association with the central organization principles of the social system, as Habermas has presented. The inner working and quality of this mutual configuration and assemblages This assemblage blend allows us to ascertain whether and how a particular social generation eventually emerges as a partial social unity, or if other distinct juvenile subgroups are still apparent. Precariat of youth or a social genocide. The difficult struggle for defining the identity and social inclusion of young people is nowadays accompanied by the crisis of deconstruction of traditional state institutions, and in general the welfare state in Europe, but much more strongly in Greece. The spirit of precarity is the spirit of modern times, and is combined with a pressure for dual readiness on the part of young people. First, to identify where they belong, and at the same time to be able to survive in an environment that constantly places them under new social and environmental risks. Through the study of important social factors presented in the Need for Youth research, such as unemployment, social marginalization, and the brain drain, we posit that the crisis of the current semi-modern regime systematically prevents the culmination of young age group into a new creative generation. Finally, it gives legitimacy to the acceptance of the overall degeneration and possible annihilation of the current generation of youth in modern Greece and the evolution that we call genocide. This is a new term. The demotion of the existence of the new generations is described by, first, the demographic biological elements, reduction of the number of young people, inability to obtain offspring, B, the inhibition of young people in the development of economic activity, C, the cultural and social frustration of young people as autonomous social entities, D, the political alienation and the re-education of young people as component of maintaining the hegemony of the semi-modernistic regime and the absence of an effective intellectual and political upstream on their part. E, the sacrifice of interest of young people in the process of tackling the Great Depression. A central question, is genocide a main historical event in modern Greece? These five processes and general attitudes of the current regimes and the political and social elites converts the legitimation and instrumental rationalization of the implementation of genocide is the biological and cultural disappearance or disassemblage of the youth as a generation. Genocide and genocide. The connotation that this concept brings with another historical concept of genocide in Europe and that has defined the fortunes of Europe in the 20th century is necessary to realizing that this process of genocide is not simply a neutral demographic process among many other social processes, but a crucial basic social development and a phenomenon that will determine the fate of the entire Greek society for the next century, as was the case with genocides that took place in Europe after the 1900s. And my final genocide, the global context. The assessment of this event of genocide may be a catalyst for the defense of the rights of young people, in Greece, in the European Union fora, but also the debt management with the new terms and mainly with the development developmental variables. Also, it will show similar events in the modern world, such the annihilation and oppression of the generation of young people in the Mediterranean Basin after the Arab Spring, as well as the impact on the emergence of Islamic terrorism from disappointed and excluded young Muslims in Europe and the Mediterranean and the Middle East. Thank you.